this time. What if I get real? What if I get real? There are shuttles in this garden here. Only blood, blood pressure. The hook line makes my ears go pop. I tell them I can stand the pressure.
Chad, welcome aboard the team, man. It's good to have you in a jam this weekend. But, you know, I forget, too, there's a little something that we like out of our riders. And we like them to be kind of clean-shaven, you know. We like to have them, you know, spiffy haircuts, you know, a little short, kind of more like a 90210 look. Just got them.
All right. Over the field, Dad.
Matthew's not sane. Anything that's dangerous, he's going to try to do. He just likes pushing the limit. He's incredible. He really is.
Insane? No. Crazy? Well, maybe a little. Pushing it? Definitely. Matt Hoffman's the guy who makes you hang onto your seat and bite your lip. The tricks are bigger, the air is higher, and the attitude is more radical than ever before. Matt is on a crusade to breathe new life back into the old sport of freestyle BMX.
Matt is doing a lot for the sport, a lot. You know, he's setting the pace, and whereas before everybody was into going and getting a big sponsorship, they wanted to go for that big deal, whereas Matt's done everything his own way. He's a rider setting the pace for other riders, which is very good for the sport.
The letters BMX stand for bicycle motocross, and that's how the sport started out in the 70s, racing on a motocross style track. By the mid-80s, bikes were big business and BMX boomed. New brand names, accessories, and clothing. There were teenage riders picking up huge sponsorship deals, but people started getting greedy, and one day the bubble burst and the sport crashed. Since its exile to the wastelands, the freestyle side of BMX has been kept alive by an element of hardcore enthusiasts. They call themselves sprocket jockeys, guys who have set about rebuilding the sport on more solid foundations. This time, the motivation's not money, it's for the love of the sport. In a derelict area outside Oklahoma City in the U.S. is where the rebirth is taking place. And this is where you'll find Matthew N. Hoffman, the Condor Man.
Hey, this is where we do all our business. Here's a Steve doing something, some accounting stuff. And then, this is kind of a random desk we threw all the mail and stuff on. That's my friend Billy. Here's some t-shirts.
How long have you been in a wheelchair for, Billy?
Going on 3 minutes now.
because Bones Hill and Chicks Dig Scars, Sprocket Jackies, Hoffman Bikes. You come in here, and this is a church I go to, and it's really convenient because it's right next door to the ramp room. It has all the ramps in it, so if we slam, we get our last ride's red doors.
Despite Matt's far-out location, this is where the sport is in the making. And fanatical freestyle BMX riders gather here from all over to pay homage, ride the ramps, and just be a part of it all.
Yeah, we got that big race going on at the Marriott, and we're in town for that. Just come down and ride the ramp and hang out and stuff like that. So it's going to be pretty crazy this weekend. A lot of people coming in. they're like the all-around riders, which means they race, they ride the mini ramp, they do freestyle, they do street riding, everything, man. They just do it all.
This week, the ramp room is extra busy because all the top guys are in town for the big dirt jumping event of the year. The rider who can pull the best trick off the dirt ramp walks away with the title of the King of Dirt. All the top guys are here, that is apart from one. And Matt's on his way to pick him up right now, very soon anyway. There he is, that's the one he's picking up.
What's up, Jordan?
Hey, can you get some help here?
Yo, man, he's wired! Haro, GT, Hoffman Bikes, all those companies. I hate them all.
Are you
going to
do the jumping contest?
Dennis McCoy is the overall freestyle world champion, which means he's mastered it all. Flatland, ramp, street, you name it, Dennis can do it.
Flatland, just whatever you can think of on flat ground, using your pegs, your brakes, rolling around, spinning, you know, involves a lot of different type of tricks. Then there's mini ramps, which is like a smaller version of the vert ramp, mostly for lip tricks. Sometimes, if they're steep enough, you can do airs on those, but mini ramps can also involve spine ramps, back-to-back ramps, hip ramps, whole wide assortment of stuff. And then there's vert riding, which is the half pipes and quarter pipes where you do big airs and hopefully don't crash and slam too hard. So that's the daredevil part of the sport, is the vert riding.
Mention the word daredevil and Matt Hoffman's right there on cue. When it comes to the vert ramp, nobody goes higher or bigger than Matt. He's doing tricks on the ramp that at one time people would have thought impossible.
That's crazy. He's weird. He's goofy. I mean, what can you say?
He's a nut. There's no limits at all. Just whatever he wants to do, he does. He's pushing it. You know, because not that many people ride to their fullest ability, and he's showing that so many people can go further with their ability.